What up, guys? Today I bring you the motherfucking war machine. He is an absolute beast. This guy's coming out here shooting freaking wrist mounted cannons left and right. He has his automated turret going all kinds of ways, swiveling, blowing freaking muffin caps off. He's freaking all over the place, dude, shooting heat beams out his chest. And worst case scenario, things aren't going his way. Let me just call in Iron Man, my sidekick, the freaking second class least favorite hero, come in and blow everybody up. It's kind of debatable, but whatever. I freaking like War Machine a ton. Had a lot of fun playing with him, passing the cosmic trial, just going in, having a good time, man. I'll go ahead and hop into the build here. I kind of start off with some of his traits. First one, weaponized. This guy's going to get base damage with the more suit power that he has. So 6% of your max suit power. You know, my current bonus is 24.4 toward my base damage. And then my damage bonus at the moment, he gets it from durability and strength. I'm at about 80%. I've seen people get, you know, well into the 200%. Once you really get good gear and really into cosmic a little bit more than I have so far. He generate heat by using certain powers. Your suit will overheat whenever it's full. Your suit will overheat, and if it's full, you will not be able to use your gun powers. In this particular range build here, this is based purely on gun powers and expelling that heat using one of the skills. War Machine's weaponry can't be used while overheated, but his hand-to-hand and sword powers are greatly enhanced. Again, that's completely different build than I chose to go with on this particular one, but you can make a hand-to-hand and sword build, which is pretty fun, but overall I don't think it's as versatile and as viable. Definitely not as fun as this particular build here. Fire automated weapon systems whenever you are in proximity to enemies. That's just your auto gun. It's going to be shooting out, it's going to be shooting, you know, every few seconds, as well as shooting off missiles. Really like that skill as well. Just give me some background DOT. Not DOT, but damage. I mean, it could be considered DOT. It's constantly active. But the armor plated, you're able to see enemies on the mini-map. Health gain, 210 health per second. This effect is tripled when you drop below 35%. Once every 10 seconds, giving him a nice little ability to gain some more health back whenever he's in a tough situation. It gets defense and deflect multipliers. And close quarters when you hit a guy with a melee power, which this isn't a melee build, so we don't have any melee powers. I'll go ahead and jump to the skills that we have here. So first off, my X. I've got it at limited war. It's going to generate a little bit of heat every time you use it. You just hold it down. It's going to do 2.3 attacks per second. Really, man, not too shabby. But more importantly, it's just going to be there whenever you do run out of your resource, whenever you run out of the resource, even call it, I didn't even say, whenever you run out of your suit power, you're going to be able to use this ability. It'll do a little bit of damage, but overall this is just kind of there just in case you run out of all means to attack. If you're out of suit power, for the most part you cannot use, I don't believe, any of his skills outside of maybe heat sink, I think, or excuse me, spitfire. But it's a good skill overall. Next up, I'll kind of talk about Spitfire and the really nice ability this gives you past that. So Spitfire, once you're at 60% here, you're going to activate Spitfire. This is going to increase your damage by 2% for that strike per heat above 60% heat. So with that being said, I mean, this is going to do a ton of damage. You're going to want to use it whenever you're maxed out on heat. It'll do, I've seen it crit for and brutal for like well over 150k. Very nice ability. It's going to load thermite rounds for you for 8 seconds, causing all your machine gun powers to ignite enemies, dealing 1385 physical damage twice per second. So this is just added damage, added crits, added brutes. Your machine gun powers are going to be limited war, suppressing fire. I know that these will get the effect, but I'm not 100% sure if they get that machine gun power, which is really interesting. So I have to double check on that real quick. But Clear the Room is up next. As you can see, Clear the Room is probably one of my favorite powers. I really like these two powers just kind of combined. This is going to clear your heat. You'll follow that up. Or you use that in contrast to Clear the Room, so you always have a power active for your machine gun. This increases your critical strike chance by 10% for 8 seconds. It's going to be a real quick animation, and it's going to do 3 hits of, you know, so far I have roughly 20k to everybody around you. Really nice ability, very quick. It's going to load those 10% increased critical chance to your machine gun powers. Just quick and easy. I'll go ahead and hop onto one of my big spenders for single target at the moment. I have Total War. He's just going to barrage people with freaking his machine guns. It's going to be shooting out rockets left and right as well. Does a ton of damage every second. So besides the cooldowns, which will do more damage, this is going to be your main kind of go-to if you're doing single target DPS to a boss. It'll get enhancements from your clear the room and your Spitfire as well. To really generate, you know, a nice damage per second ability while your other abilities are on cooldown. It is going to use a ton of freaking suit power. So I like to also use to recover my suit power, Built for War. This removes negative conditions or restores some of your suit power. It's going to only restore 40%. At the moment, it'll probably weaken to anybody around you, but how we have the spec is that it'll also revive, it'll revive you when you die. You know, you'll do a little bit of damage when you do, if you do die. If you're great like me, you won't ever die. No, just fucking around, I die all the time. But this is going to be kind of your main go-to to do a little bit of damage around you and restore your suit power. I'll follow it up with the dash that we have. You know, your basic dash, it'll knock enemies in your path kind of back, remove crowd control. I feel like this was a necessity just because he is kind of locked in place on a lot of his abilities when he attacks. He doesn't just have that shoot and run kind of play style where he can run around and just blast people. So it'll be stand there, do something, you know, stand there, do Total War, stand there, do Spitfire, and then kind of move around. So I felt that dash was a necessity to really get you out of the bad places. Then we have freaking Hammer of War. Really like this ability. You're going to shoot up a multi-purpose assault weapon, launches a thermobaric warhead, powerful enough to level a building. It'll shoot this up. You've got 2 charges the way that this is spec'd. It's going to shoot this up, take a little bit of your suit power. You have 2 charges. It's going to blow up everybody around you in a really nice big AoE. It's going to do 2800 damage twice per second. Obviously, both of those will scale with the more damage that you are able to acquire from your gear. And it's going to be on 12 second cooldown, so you have both of those recharged every 24 seconds. Very nice ability. Going to go in there, just blast this off, then just start taking people out left and right, aiming for people's heads non-stop. Very fun. And lastly, his signature Army of One is one of my favorite signatures. You fire your weapon. Which one? All of them, every single fucking one. Fire every piece of hardware you have on your person. Show them why they call you the war machine. This one's a beast. That's 34 damage twice per second. I don't even know how long it lasts. I want to say, it looks like it lasts for 4 seconds. I was going to say about 4 to 5 seconds. Going to do a ton of damage. You're going to be shooting off auto missiles, and you're going to be invulnerable, as well as doing that twice per second damage. And I want to say that this power does, in fact, get the thermite rounds as well as the anti-tank rounds, just because it changes the color of the effect whenever you use one of those powers, and that same color scheme is going to be applied to your Army of One. And I believe they also burn, so I believe they burn for more damage as well when you use that. So I'll kind of do a little bit of research after I finish recording this here and kind of put it up. See if they actually do that. I'll place it somewhere in the video, probably like right here. Next up, we have his ultimate, which is freaking fantastic. Sidekick, show Iron Man who's really the sidekick. Call him to your side and fire your repulses at each other, building up enough energy to unleash a massive localized explosion. War Machine suit is now left glowing with power. And I really like this skill, and for whatever reason, I can no longer scroll down on the ultimate abilities. This is an issue for me. Anyways, it's going to do a shit ton of damage. It's going to do, you know, roughly 200,000 damage. You'll be invulnerable. It'll produce a knockdown for everybody, and then it'll lay a I want to say for 20 seconds or so, maybe 10 seconds, it's going to lay that 13,000 damage twice per second, big radius buff on the ground. It's also going to give you a damage rating buff, critical hit rating buff. I believe it gives you some sort of buff for your suit power and like defenses and health as well. Don't quote me on that because I can't fucking see it right now. So I have no idea. This has been a problem for me for the past few 4 or 5 days now, and I will be submitting a ticket because it's pretty ridiculous. I'll go over some of his synergies, which I'm definitely not fine-tuned with this particular character. What I did to pass the Cosmic Trial, as well as what I'm kind of doing with this guy, is I'm just placing his points in durability, point blank and period. Just wanted to make sure that I have this is good because it'll give you defense, survivability. I believe it gives you health as well as increase your damage. So for me, it's a win-win. It was short and sweet and simple. And I think I put the rest of his, and yeah, just suit power. I wanted more suit power, that way I could shoot off more powers before I had to rest or, you know, shoot my real basic power, which you are able to spec out of if you get enough suit power. You can spec in something else. The talents here that I have autonomous minigun. Auto gun gives the following effect. Does 100% more damage and it generates 15 heat per second, because you're going to want to be building up heat so you can expel it as fast as possible with Spitfire, because that's going to do a large chunk of damage for you. You gain 20% damage boost in exchange. Arc Reactor, you gain the 20% damage boost in exchange for 50% suit power cost. Increase suit power to damage conversion rate. Increase. This is good. You know, you are going to spend a lot more suit power, but with that being said, you'll have a consistent 20% damage boost overall. What I originally liked to go with was Army of One, because it's going to give you a 40% damage boost for yourself and allies, and it's going to reduce your cooldown. But with that being said, overall, you know, if you're in a good group, a group of five, definitely by all means, this will be a better boost for everybody. Just everyone's DPS overall, you'll down enemies faster. If you're running around by yourself, definitely Arc Reactor. You do use more suit power, but I found that trade-off was well worth the damage boost that you get. Which is why I incorporated the real basic power in there that doesn't spend any suit power, limited war. Because you will use a shit ton of suit power. Autonomous missile deployment. War Machine periodically fires missiles at enemies automatically. You know, again, background damage, you're going to shoot 3 missiles, does 2k damage per hit every 3 seconds. Most importantly, this is going to be the Hammer of War cooldown reduced by 3 seconds, can hold 2 charges. So very nice skill there. It gives that Hammer of War 2 charges and reduces it by 3 seconds. So that way it's always on charge, it's always charging up, and you know, always on cooldown. You've got multiple charges, so you can store one and use it, you know, more frequently, or just blast both of them like I like to do when I run out. Reactive defense systems regenerate 100% of your maximum health and suit power when you are defeated. Cooldown, 10 minutes. You know, when you do die, boom, you have a power right there that's going to revive you, outside of any of your medallions or, you know, cargo rewrites, anything like that. Built for war, create a shield that absorbs damage equal to 100% of your maximum health within the next 2 seconds, and also restores 20% of your maximum health when activated. This is just going to be an overall boost to your survivability. I felt like this was a necessity when I was in Cosmic, because I had so many people coming at me nonstop, needed a shield power, and it absorbed a ton of damage. Then overclocking, heat generating powers deal 15% more damage and generate heat 50% faster. Going to constantly be getting heat back, so you can use Spitfire, which will also deal bonus damage if you have over 60% heat. Which it now states in the tooltip there, as we looked at previously. Heat decays slower while you are overheated. Not too great of a thing there, but the fact is, once you have been overheated, you're going to shoot off Spitfire every single time, immediately. It'll just be obliterating everybody. So very, very nice skill. That kind of rounds out the character. You know, my gear, I have some decent gear. You know, I played, I ran through the Cosmic Trial. I started to play Cosmic a little bit. I found some good stuff. I'm having a lot of fun with this character. One of my guys, Be More Gunny, this dude absolutely loves this character. He's a fucking beast with it. Unnaturally strong with a guy. I love playing with the guy as well, man. It's just a lot of fun to watch this guy go in and just obliterate mobs. You know, he's got him pretty much cosmic'd out. Some of the best gear that I've seen anyone have on a war machine, me in particular. But yeah, he's a lot of fun, and I like the character a lot. If you guys do have any questions, definitely shoot me a comment, like, share, subscribe. More importantly, you guys go out there and fucking love this character. Tweak him, play it. Peace out.
We dirty, young blood sucker. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I seem depressed. Always being bothered, nevertheless, keeping me out of prison and putting me to the test. They ask me what is happiness, you write it on the check. Are you feel it on the sweat when your dick is in the breast, give me a second, look. Okay. If death is what it seems, why is it so vividly portrayed within my dreams? Fear of understanding the devil's running its course. Hate is not received, it's coming straight from the source. Remorse, as this time becomes a factor, minds full of greed, disposing of benefactors. Backwards, pace backwards, effort is superficial, only reaching the surface upon the earth, and flames engulf the earth. In prized possessions, they incinerate. This is far beyond any director tried to demonstrate. See the record, here's the record, take the record, set it straight. Perplexed, only receive slumber when at heaven gates. And this is fairly simple for your grasp. Try and contemplate your conversates, hesitate and navigate your inner traits. Back to a time where minds were just matter. If you stated opinions, your bones would begin to shatter. It didn't matter back then, cause there was no reacting, acting up. Chevy and Black. Accurate fact for the black. In fact, if you thought that, you were free. You should disregard that. All facts. Young Dexter. Call me a young Dexter. My hypothesis is death ain't shit. I'd rather die than be alive in this life. Honestly, full of strife and strife. Yeah.
Service, I'm calling your bluff. I be killing these tracks till they put me in cuffs. Got no love for a slut, these hoes too hard to trust. Niggas ain't ready for the flow, sweet.
I spit like a chopper, I think I'm sick, fuck a doctor. She on my cock, so I knocked her, we on the block. No, we fogger the reef, a lot of them walk on one beat. Then go buy a whopper, cause I'm dope the fuck up. Hold the fuck up or we load the fuck up. Purple pole in my cup if I throw down how much. Let your hoe on the cut cause I'm loaded, no lux and I'm gone. Nigga in the zone low key. Got this little white thing, call her Bo Peep. Bang bang, see if she can hang when I throw deep. Later on, we can get it on with some more freaks. In exchange, my no money swing, bitch, I'm 4 deep. I don't bang, if I join a gang, give me no sleep. I got gang, so if you a lane, you don't know deep. Puffin' on some OG, cut her like a goatee. Slide in the Hornet, no New Orleans. A nigga go ham on the track, Jeff Gordon. Many beats I gotta rep before I get a check from Jordan, bruh. Bars on lock, motherfucker, I'm the warden, motherfucker, this a warning. I'm killing with the flow. If you need some fast packs, Brady got them for the low. I hit up Jalen from the phone, my nigga said that this a go. Got some beats and some heat and some freeze time blow. Shit.
You heard the rumor probably that I sold my human body to the Illuminati and now they use it to copy my brainwave patterns. I'm a master of a stupid hobby called rapping. I prove it probably when I'm right about it. Susan Boyle's age. I'll have my first hit when the world's in a no longer using. The soundtrack of apocalypse, looking back from the rocket ships, thinking I'm glad I've gotten rich in the nick of time. Intense imagination, we in places, your basic complacent mind can't relate with outside the matrix. Outline my face with chalk, we already dead, where y'all steadily trend. You walk on the path of immortal, but me and Herbal T, we are practically orbital. Trash a recordable device and all its content. Nobody feeling that nonsense.
I got the feeling that Columbus must have felt when he reached the shore of Vasco da Gama. Rama, I'm a conquistador. Venturing the territory no one's ever seen before. Rap El Dorado, let the bottle of tequila pour. Legendary Lena Horne, status for my clique. Y'all more like the Katrina storm, tragic as shit. Been doing it since the doc pulled us out by cesarean birth. It won't stop till I'm buried in earth. I'm saying, the flow so nice, it's got great karma. LOA chop the beat like a steak shawarma. Great like Parma, John Cheese on your marinara spaghetti. Ripping Maryland steady, people preparing confetti. Girls raring and ready, comparing to Betty. Grable of Maryland, wearing a teddy. We up in the Serengeti with a pair of machetes. Up in the bush with the push, motherfuckers ain't ready.
We ain't new to this, we've been doing this, since the uterus. People been asking, who is this, who is this?